Good morning, students. In the structure of an atom, we will continue next topic, quantum mechanical model of an atom. Do the electrons follow defined paths around the nucleus? If the electron revolves around the nucleus in defined paths or orbits, the exact position of the electron at various times will be known. For that, we have to answer two questions. What is the velocity of the electron? Is it possible to find the exact position of the electron? Electrons are invisible to naked eye. Then, how do you find the position and velocity of an electron? To find particles during dark nights, we take the help of torchlight, right? Similarly, we can take the help of suitable light to find the position and velocity of electron. As the electrons are very small, light of very short wavelength is required for this task. This short wavelength light interacts with the electron and disturbs the motion of the electron. Hence, simultaneously, the position and velocity of electron cannot be measured accurately. From the above discussion, it is clear that electrons do not follow definite paths in an atom. Do atoms have a definite boundary? As suggested by Bohr's model, if the electrons are not distributed in orbits around the nucleus, this means that an atom does not have a definite boundary. As a result, it is not possible to pinpoint an electron in an atom. Under these circumstances, in order to understand the properties of electrons in an atom, quantum mechanical model of atom was developed by Erwin Schrödinger. According to this model of atom, instead of orbits of Bohr's model, the electrons are thought to exist in a particular region of space around the nucleus at a given instant of time. The region of space around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum is called orbital. In a given space around the nucleus, only certain orbitals can exist. Each orbital of a stable energy state for an electron is described by a particle set of quantum numbers. We'll study quantum numbers. Each electron in an atom is described by a set of three numbers, N, L and ML. These numbers are called quantum numbers. These numbers indicate the probability of finding the electron in the space around the nucleus. This will indicate what? Where the electron is present. Okay. The quantum numbers describes the space around the nucleus where the electrons are found and also their energies. These are called atomic orbitals. Now we will see each one. Principal quantum number. N is principal quantum number. The principal quantum number is related to the size and energy of main shell. It is what? It indicates size and energy of the shell. N has positive integer values 1, 2, 3, so on. As N increases, the shells become larger and electrons in these shells are farther from the nucleus. N is increasing, shell become larger around the electron. As increase in N also means higher energy level, 1, 2, 3 are often represented by the letters K, L, M for each N where there is one main shell. Shell is nothing but K, L, M, N. N values will be K1, L2, M3 and 4. Is it clear, students? In the next class, we'll discuss next topic. Thank you.